Let's use a bit of logic to program a xylophone. This is how to learn Scratch programming language. The Scratch program language is free, fun, and easy to learn. Most program languages are text-based, so a learner has to gain experience writing the code. But Scratch program is easier, as it uses blocks. The learner selects blocks, puts them together, and runs the program in a simple way, making it the most fun and easiest way to learn programming. In task 4, we're going to create a xylophone, which is just 8 rectangles that are different colours that play notes. When doing tasks, there's always different ways we can do these tasks, and different ways to achieve the same goal. So we can use logic to find the best way. So in this example, we want you to create one of the keys, one of the rectangles, and write the instructions on how you did it. For example, here we've got some instructions. First set is 7 instructions, followed by another 8 instructions. So in total, there were 15 instructions to complete one key. And there's 8 keys, so that's 120 instructions. Is there a better way to create more keys? We can start our xylophone by creating a rectangle. So we can delete the cap, and now we're going to go to the paint option. Now we're going to create a rectangle. We start off by making the small purple rectangle. So we're going to look for the right color in the fill, and then we're going to create a small rectangle, purple rectangle. When the xylophone is clicked, we want the rectangle to change to a slightly different colour. So what we can do, we can duplicate that, so a second costume, and then we can change the fill to slightly brighter, and then use the paint option to make a slightly different colour of purple. So we go back to our code. Now when we start, we want to make sure that we're on the first costume, so switch costume to costume 1, and we also need to know where the rectangle is. So at the moment it's in this location. So if it gets moved, we want to make sure it's in the correct location. Now what happens when it's clicked? Well, first we can look for the option when this sprite is clicked. You can see here, it says when this sprite is clicked. So we need to make a note. If you haven't got the music option, you go to extension and click on music. Now here we have play note. Now, in your option, you've probably got 1 beat, so you can change it to 0.25 beats. And play note for purple, we're going to change the note to 72. Now, when it's clicked, we want to change to costume 2. So we can go back to our looks, switch costume to costume 2. And we want to change that back to costume 1 once it's been clicked. So let's test this. So that works. So we're going to create a second rectangle, so we can go to the paint option. We look back to the square, and now we want to find some type of cyan colour. So we can draw our rectangle. Let's draw a rectangle like this. We can place it. Might need to adjust the size. So let's make that slightly smaller and then put it in the location. Make that a little bit longer. Let's try that. Okay, so we do the same commands again. Duplicate. Look at our fill and create saturation that's less. Paintbrush. So now we have our two costumes. The code. Well, we can start off with the costume one and a location. So we have the location. We want to make sure we're at costume one. And then we want our, when the sprite is clicked, we want our switch to costume one and to costume two. And we want to play our note. So we're going to play our note for 0.25 beats, the same as before. And this time we're going to change the note to 71. Let's try that. So that's fine. Now we could do this with each rectangle, but is there a better way? How could you do this easier and quicker? Use duplicate. Make sure you subscribe, then you'll know when the videos are released. Well, what about duplicate? If we duplicated the sprite, the rectangle, then that might save some commands. So let's try that. So now we have a third rectangle. So we can put it in its location. And we can see that it has the same code. So let's go back to our costumes. And this time, this we want an orange color. So let's look for an orange. So we can change the color to orange. And the second costume will have slightly less saturation. That's good. And we want to make it slightly bigger. Okay. So we look for the location. That looks good. So here, if we go to our location, we can see 48 and 2. And note for the orange would be 69. So that's fine. So that made our coding a lot easier using duplicate. There is another option, and that is to move the code. So let's create another rectangle using a pink color. So let's look at the rectangle. Let's create a pink rectangle, perhaps a bit smaller. Again, duplicate, lower saturation, so this time we haven't got code because we didn't duplicate the sprite, but what we can do is we can get the code from another sprite and drag it into the new sprite. So let's go, we can see here, we've got both blocks of code. So the pink option, we're going to play the note at 67, and also we can see the location is 30 and 4. Let's try this now. That seems to work fine. We can look at the different ways that we can complete the rectangle, the key. First option, we use 15 instructions and we just repeat them. So that's 15 times 8 keys, or 8 rectangles equals 120 instructions. For option 2, we duplicated the rectangle. Here we've used 15 instructions one time and then 7 times 10 instructions. So we've lowered 120 down to 85. Option 3, we selected the color, we drew the rectangle, and then we dragged the code. Now, did we drag the code twice? If we did, then we've got the same 85 instructions. If you say dragging code is one instruction, you could say we're down to 78. But the use of duplication means that we can reduce the amount of instructions. And if you apply this to your coding, if you use logic, you can make your code work more efficiently. We've got 4 more sprites, so we can create a blue sprite. And we can draw a rectangle, put it in the correct place. Let's duplicate that. So what's the next color we're looking for? We're looking for yellow. And now let's have a look at the color. So we can use the red, the saturation. And let's look at the code, the location. And change the note. So let's have a look. Here's our xylophone. And now it works. Well, we hope you enjoyed that. Now, if you're interested in learning more or learning other programming languages, then please subscribe. And every time a video comes out, if you hit that notification bell, then that will let you know.